OK, so let's move on to St. Vincent, which is a new movie starring Bill Murray. And it's directed, written and directed by Ted Melfi, Theodore Melfi. And I don't know why that keeps making a buzzing noise. So the story is Bill Murray is this irascible drunk, and he is the new neighbour to Melissa McCarthy, who moves into the neighbourhood with her young son. She is now a single mother, and she discovers that her irascible neighbour is this drunken character played by Bill Murray. First thing that happens is his fence gets knocked down and he blames her for it. However, very quickly, he discovers that he can make money by looking after her young son, by taking her young son to the racetrack, by taking her young son, but under the guise of this all basically being babysitting. Here's a clip.
Hey! Well, hi, Mom. What are you doing?
I'm mowing Finn's lawn.
Hey, Finn!
I was sleeping. Thanks for that.
All right, let's go. I'm gonna make dinner. You can do homework.
Oh, I already ate.
Stop mowing. You're mowing dirt. Let's go.
He's fed. The homework's checked. I've done my job. I'm taking a break.
Why is he mowing your dirt patch?
Oh, yeah, he's paying me hourly.
I'm showing him how the world works. You work, you get paid, you drink.
Are you drinking alcohol?
I honestly don't remember.
The thing with Bill Murray is, I mean, I'm a huge Bill Murray fan, as I think is pretty much everybody else. And there's always the question about whether or not Bill Murray on his own can carry a film just through the sheer force of being Bill Murray. He said in one of the Press Note interviews that one of the things he really liked about Ted Melfi's script was that he doesn't really do sentimental. He doesn't do more. He likes everything to be played very, very dry. And the thing that Bill Murray does better than anybody else is dry, is deadpan, is that, you know, the stuff that you see him doing in Lost in Translation, or in fact, the stuff you see him doing in Groundhog Day. You know, he has that face which kind of looks always perpetually miserable.
And The Life Aquatic.
The Life Aquatic with Steve Zissou, which I like very much. I mean, I think you enjoyed that as well. I think we watched it together.
Yes.
Odd, then, that in the case of St. Vincent, in which the basic plot thing is that you know that during the course of this relationship between this young boy and this old grouchy guy, that they will both find some kind of common ground, that somehow the young boy will actually discover a subject for his project about sanctity in the modern age, hence the St. Vincent title. You also know that Bill Murray will somehow open up and, you know, come out of this kind of cocoon in which he has encased himself, and we will discover things about him, about his past, that sort of explain why he is as he is. However, it is without doubt rampantly schmaltzy and sentimental in a way which is kind of at odds with the sort of stuff that you expect from Bill Murray, which is a weird one, because all the moments in which it works are the moments between Bill Murray and the little kid, in which they're doing that sort of, you know, chewing the cud, ruminating on philosophical matters in a very dry, very deadpan fashion. And all the moments that it falls apart are the moments when you can feel the music starting to run and think, and people start to make big declarative speeches. Have you ever seen that thing, Movie Trailer? You know, the thing that, which is the sort of compilation of all the movie cliches from any film that ever won Best Picture.
Compilation.
What? Compilation.
Compilation, yes, okay. Just checking. It was a rare Americanism from you.
Okay, thanks for picking me up on that.
Thank you. Well, you are the king of pickups, so I just thought I'd...
The king of pickups?
So that back at
you. I've never been called that before. I've completely lost where I was. No, I haven't, yes. So it is weird that the movie has so many. And in fact, funnily enough, if you look at the poster for it, which is one of those things in which there are airbrushed pictures of all the leads sort of smiling and doing that kind of beamy smiling, you think, actually, the film that I wanted to see was the film with him being gruff, him being grouchy, him being narky, him being, you know, sort of snidey and being Bill Murray. And I don't need to have it completely drenched in treacle. There's also a strange thing going on with the Naomi Watts character, which is that she is this Russian stripper, and we were talking before about Jude Law's Aberdonian accent. Well, believe me, Naomi Watts gives him a run for his money in terms of the most off the peg accent that I am having now. It is, you know, I am Daka, and
that's,
I
like
am
from the Muppets movie.
It is really, I am Kermit the Frog, and I am being played by Naomi Watts. I mean, it is that level of poor.
We were just getting back in with Naomi, and now you've put us back about another year.
Sorry. If anybody goes to see St. Vincent, and, you know, many will, because actually it's enjoyable, it's kind of fun, and, you know, Bill Murray's always going to have to say the relationship between him and the kid works out very well. But when Naomi Watts comes in, do you want a little bit of it? Okay, here we go.
He'll pay $100. He said This is for epilepsy, for prostate flaring.
Yes.
That should have some value.
For who? You? He said 100 win. You take it or leave this. You can't sell this to get high.
That's how they talk in Peckham.
Take it or leave it. You can't sell this to get high. Okay.